Hello, welcome to my today's videos. Don't forget to subscribe.
We're going to look at probability, and as we know, probability is a numerical measure of chances. That simply means that if you have got a coin which has got two sides, a head and a tail, the chances of getting the head when you toss or a tail when you toss are equal, since it is only two sides. And we normally find probability of a particular event by taking the number of favorable outcomes over the total number of trials. This we mean that, for instance, if you have got a dice and you toss it, for instance, 25 times, if you toss it 25 times, you will have to see, for instance, the first side 4 times, the second side 5 times, the third side 1 time maybe, the fourth side 3 times, the fifth side maybe 9 times, and the sixth side 2 times. If somebody asks the probability, for instance, of seeing the coin 4 times, it shall be the event, the probability, the event is 4 times. It is the total number of times that it can be seen, or the outcome is 3, over the total number of tries that has been tossed. When you add 4 plus 5 plus 1 plus 3 plus 9 plus 2, you will get 25. So it shall be 25. So the probability of seeing 4 is 3 out of 25. On top of that, I have got a question here. 2 concentric circles are such that the larger one has a radius of 6 centimeters and the smaller one a radius of 4 centimeters. Find the probability that an item dropped lands on the shaded region. So when they say concentric circle, they simply mean 2 circles that have got one center. 2 circles that have got one center. So the shaded region we are referring to is this one. So therefore, the smaller radius is 4. And the bigger radius is 6. So we are being asked, what is the probability that when you drop an item, it will land here and not here? So to get that probability, as we have seen up here, that probability of an event is the number of favorable outcomes over the total number of trials. In this case, we shall have the probability of it landing in the shaded region shall be the shaded area over the larger area. This shall be calculated by pi r squared minus r squared over pi r squared. So from this you can see that pi and pi, when you simplify, you will remain with r squared minus r squared over r squared. So when you substitute, we'll have our bigger r is this and our smaller r is that. Therefore, that is 6 squared minus 4 squared over 6 squared, which it is going to be 20 over 36. And when you simplify, 4 here, 5, and 4 here, 9. Therefore, our answer is 9, 5 over 9. And the probability of an object landing in the shaded region is 5 over 9.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Bye bye.